What is going on, everybody? Welcome to the next audio commentary. The next thing we are going to be watching is iZombie, Season 1, Episode 1. Now, if you guys want to watch the episode with me, the timestamp is currently at 1 second. So, as per usual, I'm going to be counting down from 3, and then once I say 1, you hit play. So, without further ado, 3, 2, 1, play. Life before death. And I gotta say, she barely has any color difference from then to now. Like, she definitely has a little bit more color in her skin, but it's not much compared to how she is now. But either way, she is freaking hot. And you know what's funny? Every time after an episode of The Flash or Arrow, I think it's The Flash. Yeah, it's The Flash because Flash comes on before iZombie. You hear her Australian accent and I'm just like, damn. Like, there are certain actors who you know have an accent and they cover it with an English accent. Then you hear their real accent and you're just like, I can't believe they actually sound like that in real life. Like, it's such a big difference. Currently, the only people that are like that for me that I'm just so surprised by is John Boyega and her. And I just gotta say, what kind of first name is Major? You know, I just realized that's pretty funny. The beginning of this episode feels like a typical CW show. And that's probably what threw some people off. And just so you guys know, I'm currently watching season 2. I'm caught up. I watch it every time, pretty much every night there's a new episode. And so I barely remember season 1 that much. I mean, I remember what happens, but it's been so long since I've seen it since the beginning that it's sort of blind for me. Which pretty much goes with everything else I've been doing on this channel so far, is that pretty much most of the stuff that you guys are seeing is pretty much stuff I haven't seen in a very long time. I am already dead. I love that theme. I hate her mother. You just don't understand. See, the problem is, she doesn't crave dick anymore. She craves brains. So basically, she's every teenager after they get out of high school. PTSD. I know some people that suffer from PTSD, and I don't really think they know exactly. I don't know, PTSD to me, from the people I know that actually suffer from it, they suffer from it a lot worse, and I don't think she reacts in the same way actual people who suffer from PTSD actually react to. I'll be honest, I got lost in my words right there. God, he looks skinnier. God, I love Robbie. Ravi might be my favorite character. It'd be him, and then Liv. Is it weird that she makes this food looked delicious? I feel like there's something wrong with me because, you know, she's eating human brains and it looks delicious. I watch Hannibal and he makes his food look delicious. And I want to eat both of those. The eager ally. Yeah, he. Huh? Yeah, he looks really skinny compared to now. He seems like he's taller and also a little bit bigger. Also, I think he's much more hairier. Now. Yeah. He's much more hairier now than he was then. Funny, I actually don't remember them mentioning Utopian in the first episode. You know, Blaine looks really creepy when he goes full on zombie mode. I wonder how she found that out. The hell? That scared the living shit out of me. I'm so sorry about that. I was pretty much saving the video file for the Spectacular Spider-Man Episode 1 audio commentary, and it just finished. So, yeah, sorry. Sorry I did that. I should have muted my mic. Or not muted my mic, muted my computer. My ass is falling asleep right now. Because I'm sitting in a wooden chair. And now we have Psych 2.0. Oh yeah, he did. He was new to the Force. Well, new to this police force. Why does she need a plastic eyeballs? Okay, yeah, my ass is falling asleep. Oh God. Yeah, her mom reminds me so much of, she's just too controlling. Pretty much wants to control her daughter's life to her own idea. That's a creepy face. That's I forgot about. I forgot he was in the show. He's got a point. Okay, that cop right there that's walking away, that's bald. That was a really weird walk. It was like he was strutting his stuff. It was kind of odd. Damn. This reaction, he's like, you've got to be fucking kidding me. Boom. The investigation. Liar. That's Mamba. I don't know, man. If you keep calling her just to get some roleplay sex out of it, you better send her a Christmas card. Just don't send her any money because you're pretty much paying her already. Funny thing is, in the last episode, he actually stated he hates zombies. And the way he said it, he was more like he was scared of them. I don't know why, it was kind of funny to hear him call her emo. I don't have a problem with people who are emo. But I'm just saying, you know, just the way he said that, it's just, for some reason, it sounded funny. She's probably going to smell some semen. If she opened a door like that to me, she would have so much semen all over her. I just went freaking NC-17 right now, but goddamn it, that attire. Goddamn. Did she just call him Cop NBC? Nah, she's hiding shit. The way she's acting. Couldn't you just look up her real name on Google or something? Just like type in Tatiana porn star and you most likely will find a name. I wonder what klepto means. I never actually heard that before. Kleptomaniac? I might have to look up the definition. And I'm pretty sure it's right in front of me, too. Now, that's not fun. Anyone who has a fear of heights probably can't watch that, because I kind of had to close my eyes. I kind of had to close my eyes when they showed that. The rise and fall. I just realize how weird it is that porn stars slash hookers is basically the plot of the first episode of iZombie. You know, I was just questioning that too. After this episode, and I think, hopefully it's after this episode, you know, the other brain she starts to eat, she actually develops the personality of the person she ate. In this one, she doesn't actually develop the personality, but they did show a little bit of a hint of it right there. She's still the same Liv, but in other episodes, once she eats the brain, you know, she's still Liv, but her personality pretty much resembles the person she, you know, ate the brain of. I don't know how I feel with her, but I don't know how I feel about her wearing lipstick. Like, she looks pretty, but kind of looks weird compared to her skin complexion. Like, it's just a little too red, or pink, whatever color that is. It's like, it's pink. It's a little, it's more pink than red. Yeah, Dying Light. I actually thought Dying... I knew he played games, but I thought Dying Light came in a little later. The pity party. You can tell that guy looks like a jerk. What did you say, pens? Or pants? Pens. Well, you can have sex, just not with humans. That thing is just creepy looking. Ravi's little smirk. Goddamn accent. Bearded pig. I remember they did that, but I thought she did it before she went to Babino. The big sleep. God, he's going full on Dexter on them. Plastic everywhere. Maybe if he didn't cheat, this shit wouldn't happen. Which is sad too, because if he were to win in this, he would continue cheating. Most likely. Check your corners. Oh yeah, block him off. Sorry about that. Someone opened my door, and I told them to go because I'm recording. This was a pretty badass scene right here. I don't remember if he died or not. And, you know, if he didn't see him, you know, if he didn't see Babino, he would have shot the girls. You know, with how built Major is and the way his costume is designed, he looks like a video game character. I can't think of the video game, but he looks like a certain video game mad scientist character. I am really hungry right now. I could go for some brains. God, that's gonna be really scary. All right, so that is it for episode 1 of iZombie, season 1. I hope you guys enjoyed the audio commentary. I'm sorry for the little... It wasn't really much of an interruption, but, you know, my door opening and then closing. I'm sorry you guys had to hear that, but things happen. And plus, the person that opened the door was half asleep, so I can't really blame them. So, that is it. I hope you guys enjoyed the audio commentary, and I will see you guys again on episode 2 of iZombie.